Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. And for today's video, I'm going to do a foundation review. And if you guys are interested on this foundation, then just keep on watching. So for today's video, I'm going to review this CoverGirl Clean Fresh Skin Milk Nourishing Foundation. This is their newest one. And this one, it is a dewy finish and it is vegan. And they have 14 shades of this one. And I did grab the medium shade. So this one, it does have 30 ml or 1 fluid ounces here. And it's a tube. Compare it to the pump one usual, and this one is $11.99. Claims that this is for all skin types, and it doesn't have parabens, sulfates, phthalates, mineral oil, and it is cruelty free. And it claims that it is lightweight, nourishing liquid foundation. Gives your skin the moisture boost. Is infused with milky coconut milk and aloe vera. It claims also that it gives you glowy, dewy finish that lasts all day long, blurring imperfections and creating a more even skin tone. So basically it's like kind of tinted moisturizer or what do you call those hydrating foundation that are latest new trend nowadays. For this side, I'm going to use the brush, and this one is going to be a sponge, wet sponge. Primer, I'm going to use this one. This is the Ciara London Watermelon Burst Hydrating Primer. So by the way guys, before I'm going to apply this foundation, I'm going to tell you guys I have a combination skin. It means I have dry skin and oily skin on the T-zone, and then later on, as you guys can see, I am prone to acne. And you guys can see I have another new one right there, and because of my hormones, so it's like doubled it up. Now I'm going to apply this one first. I'm going to shake it a little bit. Maybe put some like this. As you guys can see, hopefully this is a right shade for me. Right here. A brush. Okay, as you guys can see on this side, it does even out a little bit of my skin complexion, but it doesn't have any coverage at all. So it's like kind of moisturizing, tinted moisturizer. And then on this side, because I didn't put much of the primer, it gives me like a little bit of tiny pieces of like kind of dry patches right here and on this side also. So now I'm going to apply here with this sponge and see which one is the better application. It's like coconut milk with kind of oatmeal. I don't know. It smells like oatmeal extract, but doesn't have that one, so I think it's the coconut oil or coconut milk. So you guys can see right here, I'm gonna zoom you guys out, I'm gonna zoom it. It does have a little bit of tiny pieces that is formed in whenever I apply it right here and on the top of my forehead. I don't know what is that. As you guys can see, it's much more easier to apply it with a wet sponge, and I think it's because I'm not used to use a brush to apply a foundation or a face base. But as you guys can see, this one is much more better than this one, so I'm going to just try to even out the whole thing. I'm just gonna go powder a little bit. I'm going to use this one. I'm going to powder the T-zone just in case. And I'm going to show you guys what I'm like noticing about this foundation. First, I'm going to zoom you guys in. As you guys can see right here, it did made a patchy, white patchy or cast right here. And I didn't even apply any powder on this side. And it started to be like a little bit sticky. When I did apply some powder, it started to have this kind of white stuff on my nose. And then on this side, it, like you guys can see. And then the other one also. So it's like a white stain like stuck in there. Usually for a foundation, it doesn't show it like that. And then my forehead on this side of my hair, it is a little bit dry. I guess I need to apply some primer on that side too. Should I set it? I'm going to set it with this Illuminating Prime and Fine Dewy Glow Fixing Spray by Catrice Cosmetics and see if we're gonna go away the white stain over there. So the setting spray, it did not help me on the nose section where the white stuff is in there. I think it's foundation stuck in there that is so dry, and still have the white stain on my top of my nose. So we'll figure out later how is this foundation. And currently it is 12:53 p.m. So I'm going to check in later on for you guys how it looks like on the skin. So far, it just like kind of tinted moisturizing foundation, I guess. It's too lightweight. It's so sheer that I can't even cover it up my acne scarring right there. But it does even out my skin though, so I'll be right back with the check-in later with you guys. So guys, I'm back, and currently it is 4:55 p.m. Now I'm going to tell you guys what I've been seeing after 4 hours. Still the same right here when I applied it, and the only thing that is not good is when I started to have two bumps right here, and I don't know, these ones are not here a while ago, and I'm starting to have another one right here and one more right there. It does have the it defines the line right here a little bit, as you guys can see both sides. And I did have a white cast right here now, as you guys can see, and here, and it's a little bit sticky. I'll be right back with you guys for my last check-in for this foundation, and I'm going to tell you guys if I like it or not. So guys, I'm back for my last check-in for this foundation, and it is currently 8:54 at night. And for this foundation, as you guys can see, still in my face, it didn't move much like other foundation, like especially the matte formula ones. And for me, I think this one is not really hydrated moisturizer or a foundation for me. I told you guys a while ago, I have the currently bumps, like little bumps starting to form on my face, and it does have some of the lines over here, and it is a little bit sticky. For this one, I'm not sure if this one is acne prone friendly because of the coconut milk in here. Although it does have aloe vera, but the main ingredient of this foundation is coconut milk. It's not advisable for the people that are acne prone, and coconut milk is like good for your skin, at the same time it's not good for some people's skin type. Other than that, I'm going to test it out more and see if this is the one that gives me the bump in here. And I'm going to use a different hydrating primer with this one, and or maybe I'm going to use a different setting spray also. And I think that's it for you guys. I hope you guys like this video. Please give this a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do. So that's it, and thanks for watching. Bye. Give me your